Chapter 53. Papa, take good care of yourself. I'll go out and get revenge for you. Be very careful, my child. Deng Chengyu went to the city wall and shouted a challenge. Jiang Ziya was talking with his generals in the silver security court when he received the report. He pondered silently for a long while. Prime Minister, you fought 1,000 battles without ever being frightened. Why are you startled at the news of a woman general? Huang Feihu asked. There are three things to be wary of in war: Taoists, Buddhist monks, and women. Most are skilled in sorcery. I'm worried that you may be hurt if you don't guard against their magic. Jiang Ziya explained. Your disciple Nijia is willing to meet her, master. You may go, Nijia, but you should be very careful. Jiang Ziya cautioned him. Nijia mounted his wind fire wheels and left the city. He saw a beautiful young woman galloping toward him. Don't be in such a hurry, Lady General. Nijia yelled. Who are you? Deng Chengyu demanded. I'm Nijia. You are just a girl, not yet fully developed. How dare you flaunt your courage on the battlefield? As a member of the fairer sex, don't you feel ashamed to face us? You may know something about warfare, but you won't find it easy to escape defeat if you battle with me. Return and ask someone else to come in your place. You hurt my father. I'll make you feel the edge of my cutlass. Deng Chengyu shouted angrily. She flushed with rage and gnashed her teeth. She spurred her horse forward and struck at Nijia. Nijia returned her blow with his fire-tip lance. After several rounds, Deng Chengyu thought to herself. Better to make the first move. She pulled her horse out of the fight and ran away, calling. I'm no match for you. Nijia nodded to himself. She's a girl, after all, and naturally, can't stand up to a long fight. He set off in pursuit. Deng Chengyu turned, and when she saw Nijia close behind her, she quickly hung her cutlass on the saddle, took out a shining pebble, and hurled it into his face. His nose and eyes were badly hurt. When Nijia returned to the Prime Minister's mansion, Jiang Ziya inquired about his wound. He described what had happened. Be very careful next time. Jiang Ziya commented. Huang Tianhua cut in sarcastically. A general should constantly watch all directions and listen to everything around him. How could you have failed to stop a small stone? The bridge of the nose represents Saturn. Now that you've had your Saturn broken, not only will your appearance be ruined, you'll also have bad fortune throughout your life. Nijia was furious. Not only was he wounded, but he had also been coldly ridiculed by Huang Tianhua. Deng Chengyu returned to tell her father that she had defeated Nijia and wounded him with her pebble. Deng Jiugong was delighted at the news, but was still in great pain from the wound on his shoulder. The next day, Deng Chengyu gave another challenge. Who would like to meet her? Jiang Ziya asked. Your disciple Huang Tianhua would like to meet her. Be very careful. Jiang Ziya repeated. Huang Tianhua mounted his jade unicorn and left the city. Deng Chani Olu forward on her horse and asked. Who's that general coming? 1081. I'm Huang Tianhua, the eldest son of Prince Huang Feihu. Are you the cheap hussy that hurt my brother yesterday? I'll make you pay for it. Don't go away. He struck at Deng Chengyu with his hammers, and she resisted him with her cutlass. After several rounds, she once more pulled out of the fight and ran away, shouting. Dare you chase me? If I don't, Nijia's sure to ridicule me. Huang Tianhua thought and set off in determined pursuit. Hearing him close behind, Deng Chengyu put her cutlass on the saddle, stealthily took out a pebble, and threw it forcefully at Huang Tianhua. Huang tried to evade it, but it was already too late. He was hit in the face and wounded even more seriously than Nijia. Bleeding profusely, he covered his face with one hand and fled back to the city. When Huang Tianhua entered the Prime Minister's mansion, Jiang Ziya was surprised to find that he too had been seriously wounded. Why weren't you more careful? That cheap hussy moved so fast that I didn't have the time. Rest well, and let your wound heal. In the rear chamber, Nijia heard that Huang Tianhua had returned with a wounded face. He was eager for revenge and went to find Huang Tianhua. A general should constantly watch all directions and listen to everything around him. Wounded by a weak woman. Fortune tellers regard the bridge of nose as the root of a mountain. To have it broken means bad luck for at least 100 years. He ridiculed Huang Tianhua. Why do you repeat what I said to make fun of me? How can you be so petty-minded? Huang Tianhua said furiously. Why did you insult me yesterday? Nijia refuted angrily. They quarreled so fiercely that Jiang Ziya had to interfere. Stop it. Both of you were wounded serving the king. Why carry on like this? Nijia and Huang Tianhua felt ashamed. They stopped quarreling and retired to their own chambers. Deng Chanyu returned to the Shang camp with another victory. Deng Jiugong was pleased that his daughter had won two successive victories, but the pain from his shoulder was still intense, and the days seemed to drag out like years. The next day, Deng Chanyu rode to the city wall again with a new challenge. Who will go to meet her this time? Jiang Ziya asked. Yang Jian said to Dragon Beard Tiger. You're the one to meet this woman. She throws stones just as you do. You confront her, and I'll go along as support. At his proposal, Dragon Beard Tiger volunteered. I'll meet her, and Yang Jian will back me up. With Jiang Ziya's approval, He and Yang Jian left the city at once. Deng Chanyu was startled to see a queer creature leap out from the city. His hands were like the claws of an eagle, and his single foot was that of a tiger. His body was covered in scales, and he had a beard like the antennae of a lobster. Frightened out of her wits, she asked, "What kind of creature are you?" Dragon Beard Tiger replied angrily, "You cheap wench. I'm Dragon Beard Tiger, a disciple of Prime Minister Jiang. What are you doing here? By order of my master, I've come to do battle with you." Deng Chanyu did not know that there were rocks concealed in his hands. All of a sudden, he opened his palms, and stones and boulders immediately flew out at her like a great swarm of locusts. Sand and dust churned in the air, making a fearful noise. These stones are coming thick and fast. Deng Chanyu thought. If I'm not careful, I'll get hit. She turned her horse and ran away with Dragon Beard Tiger in pursuit. Deng Chanyu then seized a chance to cast a pebble. Dragon Beard Tiger lowered his head to evade it, but it hit him forcefully on his lone oak. Deng Chanyu immediately threw another stone, knocking him to the ground. She then turned her horse around and raced back to cut off his head. What became of Dragon Beard Tiger? If you want to know, read the next chapter.